sound, chapter number 13 sound. First video we have studied in the previous lecture. In this lecture we are going to start about what is amplitude, what is frequency, what is pitch, what do we mean by oscillation, and what do we mean by time period here. So here in this chapter we are going to study about the first point, that is amplitude. What is amplitude here? So whenever you know that sound is, what is sound? Before in the previous lecture I have told you that sound is nothing but a kind of vibration. Okay, so according to this it is like with the amplitude. So what is the amplitude? Amplitude is the maximum distance traveled by a point on a vibrating body. So suppose let's take an example. Suppose this is a bob, I am holding it here, and if I oscillate it like this, this is the main point. If I oscillate it like this, so this oscillation is going on here, means from the main point what happened, a body is moving from one point to the another on a vibrating body. This oscillation sometimes it moves more forward, means to high, and sometimes it will move on the place itself. So according to this, it can be, the amplitude can be represented in the form of waves also, and it can be represented in the form of oscillation also. So first, what is amplitude? It is the maximum distance traveled by a point from one point to the another. Like this is a bob moving here. Sometimes this bob moves from here to here. If I move it more, so what will happen? This bob will move from here to here. Means what is oscillation here? To and fro of the bob body. To and fro movement of the body is known as what? Oscillation. So from here, sometimes it will move more forward, and sometimes it will move on its place. So it is doing oscillation, but sometimes forward, sometimes more high it goes, and sometimes at the same place it travels. So what is the oscillation here? Oscillation is the maximum distance traveled by the mean point from one point to the another on a vibrating body. Mean point means, suppose mean point means here. This is the mean point. From here it moves this side, and after this it comes back to the place, and again it moves this side. So what is happening here? Oscillation is happening. So this amplitude can be represented in the form of oscillation also, and in the form of waves. Waves means in this way. This is a kind of waves. So in this way also is oscillation, the frequency is moved, and in oscillation also you can check the amplitude. Okay? So let's take one example here. Suppose we represent this in the form of oscillation and waves. Oscillation I told you, in waves, this is the y-axis.
From the highest point to the lower point, that is known as the
sum will be there. Means here if I draw this graph like this and it contains this much, means here it is covering less amplitude, so the less sum will be produced. Here it is covering more amplitude, so more sum will be produced here.
In 1 second, if it makes 3 oscillations, so what will be the
20 volts. Okay, so this is nothing but oscillation is to and fro motion of an object. You have seen that clock is there, na? In olden days, this type of clock were there, this type of clocks were there, and one pendulum was there. So whenever it struck 12, this pendulum started rotating from one place to the another.
Speak in a higher pitch, that person will feel that how rudely you are talking.
time taken by a pendulum to complete one complete oscillation, that is known as what? The time period. Suppose this is the pendulum. It moves here and then it moves here. So means one